Hello and welcome to another TubeBuddy tutorial here at Small YouTubers Boost. Today we're going to be talking about the demonetization audit. This is a function that is available in both the free and paid versions of TubeBuddy. If you're not aware, TubeBuddy is a website, browser plugin, and mobile app that helps you manage your channel. If you don't have TubeBuddy, I recommend installing it using the affiliate link down below. This video is not sponsored. Today we're going to be focusing on one function of the browser plugin called the demonetization audit. The demonetization audit is great for channels that are monetized and don't want individual videos being automatically demonetized. But for smaller channels that haven't yet been monetized, it's also a good idea to use this tool because if you want to monetize your channel in the future, you're going to want to make sure that you're doing your best to make sure your individual videos won't get demonetized at that time. As well, more of your videos being in compliance with YouTube's standards increases the likelihood that your channel will be approved during the monetization review process. The demonetization audit will appear on your upload and edit video screens, both in the classic and modern version of YouTube Studio on the desktop. As you can see in this picture here in the bottom right hand corner, the demonetization audit is showing no warnings, so you get a green check mark and everything is fine. If, after installing the TubeBuddy browser plugin, you don't see the demonetization audit function on your upload or edit video screens, then you need to check your settings on the TubeBuddy website. On the TubeBuddy website, click Setup and Settings on the left-hand side and make sure that you have selected Show Demonetization Audit on the Info and Settings page and Upload page. So as you can see here, I've gone to edit the settings on one of my videos. I've added a bunch of inappropriate words to the description, seeing which ones the demonetization audit thinks could cause this video to be demonetized. And in this case, it's picked up on two words that I entered that are likely to get this video demonetized. So all I have to do is remove those two words and then I'll be back to the green check mark and my video is much less likely to be demonetized. That was the classic version of Creator Studio. In the modern version of Creator Studio, it works much the same way. As you can see here in this screenshot, in the bottom right-hand corner, the demonetization audit is showing no warnings and a green check mark. Everything is fine. Here in the modern version of Creator Studio Beta, I've added some inappropriate words to the description of this video. The demonetization audit has picked up on those words and issued me a warning. As you can see, the orange-yellow sign saying warning and the red words listed out that are likely to get this video demonetized. One thing to note for users of Creator Studio Beta, if you go to edit your title and descriptions from the videos list, as seen here, the demonetization audit does not appear. So you're not going to want to edit this way because then you won't have the benefit of the demonetization audit watching what you enter and giving you a warning if it's inappropriate. Once again, if you haven't already installed TubeBuddy, I highly recommend you do so using the affiliate link down below. The demonetization audit function does appear in both the free and paid versions of TubeBuddy, so whichever version you're using, I highly recommend you make use of this tool to prevent your videos from being demonetized in the future. If you're thinking about upgrading your TubeBuddy license to a paid version, make sure that you join the Small YouTubers Boost Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/smallyoutubersboost and check the announcement section for a special code that'll save you 20% off all paid plans of TubeBuddy. The demonetization audit is a simple but vital function in TubeBuddy. And so I'm curious, what's your favorite TubeBuddy function so far? Comment below and let us know, and if we don't already have a video to show you how to get the most out of that function, we can see about making one in the future. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial video. If you found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up to help other people discover this video. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel, and I recommend turning notifications on. We often have live streams with very little notice, and we take requests in chat in the order in which people speak. So the earlier you join a live stream, the earlier we can get to your question or request. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the comments.